Eek Nani presents an exclusive interview with Rama Palaniappan, the author of Zero EMI, Unlock Your Financial Freedom. Palaniappan is a keynote speaker with over 15 years of industry experience as a banker and IT program manager. His book helps us to learn how to control our finances and lead a debt-free life. If you are keen to know more about his writing journey, please watch this interview.
Thank you, Palani, for your time for this interview with Eek Nani. We have a set of questions for you. And the first one is, how long have you been writing?
Thank you, Ali, for this interview. It all started way back in 2012 when I joined Toastmasters first. Toastmasters, for those who do not know what it is a global organization which helps its members to improve their public speaking skills. It requires its members to give a number of speeches. So for me to give the first speech, it is for 4 minutes actually. I wrote down the complete script of my speech and I reviewed it multiple times with my friends, with my wife and with my mentor. It all started there with a 4 minute speech. And later on for my subsequent speeches also, I wrote down my scripts for the speeches. My wife then, when she was reviewing it, told me once that I'm writing good. Remember, this is coming from my wife.
Yeah.
And you all know how difficult it is to get a compliment from a spouse, right?
Absolutely.
So I believed in it. And then I took it a little serious. And from then on, I started honing my writing skills. But little did I know that I'll become an author one day. The credit actually goes to Toastmasters and my wife who made this possible.
Wonderful. Great. And how has been your overall writing experience so far?
I usually start writing very early in the morning, around 5:30 a.m. That's a pretty quiet time without any disturbance. The early morning hours helps for a focused writing.
Okay.
A cup of coffee, a notebook, my laptop, and that is how I start writing in the morning. And it transports me to a different world, and I thoroughly enjoy being in such state. Whether I share it with the outer world or not, I do write every day and keep it with me. And I'll not squeeze my brain to bring out anything. Once the thoughts stop flowing, I stop writing as well. Then comes the next day, then I follow the same routine. That is how I've been traveling. I also spend time to review what I wrote and fine-tune it. Once I don't have any new thoughts for the day. Every day, this is the routine for me and I love going through this experience.
Wonderful. Can you tell me something about your book?
Absolutely.
Zero EMI?
Yeah. Zero EMI was written out of my life experience and my experience as a banker. So one of the researchers says that 90% of the people work for EMI and not for anything else. Many are in tremendous pressure to earn money just to repay their loans. Many do not love the job that they do. We are seeing a lot of people, right, who do not love the jobs, but they go to jobs just because they want to pay their EMIs.
Correct.
And there are people who do a lot of adjustments in their work life because they have loans to repay. We are living in an era of instant gratification wherein we lost the patience to wait, the patience with the tree to yield fruits, the patience to earn and spend. And if you are one among them, you're watching this interview, and if you are one among them, deep into EMIs and wanting to get rid of EMIs, organize your finances better and want to achieve financial freedom, then I strongly urge you to read my book, Zero EMI. The book has answers to all your questions about personal finance. I try to explain many complex financial concepts in a simple English with the use of my personal stories. My only wish is that everyone in this world must lead a stress-free life financially. And everyone deserves it. And everyone can do that. So it's a very light, quick-read book which could create a long-lasting impression in your financial life. The physical book can be ordered online, Ali, during this pandemic in amazon.in.com.co.uk. Flipkart and Notion Press. And also the ebook can be bought in Amazon Kindle, iBooks, Kobo and Google Play stores. So I'm sure the readers will find it useful after reading.
Absolutely. Yes, and for the benefit of the listeners, we will have those links in the description below. And they can probably later go on and purchase the book. We also want to know from you, Palani, it's not an easy task to finish writing a book, isn't it? You might have faced some difficult times during the completion of the book. So what was the lowest point of your writing journey when you were actually writing this book, Zero EMI?
There were many challenges. No, you're right. There are many challenges in completing the complete project itself, right? At times, your mood may not be as good as the previous day was. You were able to write so well, but the next day you were not able to write because you needed some rest, the extra hours of sleep. You couldn't get up early in the morning, all of that. And I'm also working full time. With these challenges, you know, I usually spend my weekends and the early morning hours to complete this project. And book publishing is something very new to me. I'm a first-time author. So the steps involved or the task involved in publishing a book is something not known to me. I have to actually work with the publisher in order to get all the tasks. And also there is a single point of contact the publishing house has appointed with whom I work very closely. A lot of interaction that happens. Sometimes I'm not available for to talk because I have my office work, and at times that person is not available to talk. So these kind of timing challenges was a primary thing which I had to handle it, and then I had to take a special permission to make the person available either early in the morning or later in the evening. So the publishing house also gave a lot of flexibility in terms of, you know, making that person available according to my schedule. So these are some of the challenges that I faced. And the editing and book cover also took a lot of time. Editing is a time-consuming process, but the value addition that it brings to the table is enormous. So I think it's worth the time spending, but it's a lot of back and forth communication between the editor and myself in order to complete the project on time. When you're reading the same script, you know, 10 times, 20 times, this script is a huge one, right? The entire book for 10 times, 20 times, then it becomes very tiring as well. So these are some of the challenges.
Okay, great. And you have been through all those challenges. And what was the point, the highest point?
The cover design. When I actually saw the initial thoughts about the cover, I really love the design of the cover. The creator have created a wonderful design for my book, and I'm not a creative person actually, so I need to actually rely on someone else to, you know, do the creative work. And the concept of having a lock and a key and adding that E, if you look at the book cover, you know, those who have the book or, you know, see yes. it in the website, the lock and the key. With the key, the E starts actually. EMI's E starts. So the entire idea is, you know, this is the book which can actually unlock, you know, it's a key to unlock Correct. Your financial freedom. You know, there are a lot of closed locks in the background throughout. So after seeing this cover design, I was actually flying in the air. I jumped out of joy. I have no words to, you know, if that person is in person, and I would have gone and hugged him tight, but, you know, we were working in the virtual world. But no, kudos to Mojo Canvas, Arun Kumar, for that design. I must mention his name here. He did a wonderful job, really.
Amazing cover, yes. It is very attractive.
Right. No, it aptly conveys the message of the book.
Correct. Okay. And how did you decide the title of the book?
That is again, you know, humongous task. You know? Title is the first thing that an author can convey to the readers. And it's actually an elevator pitch of your book, you know, rather I could say. And it must make the readers to turn their attention toward your book. Correct. It took a lot of time for me to finalize my book title. And in fact, I finished writing the entire book without a title, believe me. Okay. Because I was still deciding on a lot of various titles. The first one I decided was zero or not zero EMI, actually financial freedom, a debt-free way. That was the title I first decided. And then I came up with a lot of probabilities, you know, playing with a lot of words here and there, and finalized, worked with my friends, mentors, and my wife also to actually help me to pick the right title. Zero EMI was not recommended by anyone. Their choice was actually something else.
Okay.
However, I was somehow very convinced with zero EMI. I thought it's very short and it's very catchy. I felt the title will stand out. I went ahead with my intuition and titled my book as Zero EMI. Some of my friends also did not like it, but still, you know, I told them, hey, sorry, you know, I'm going with Zero EMI. I value your thoughts, but I'll go with Zero EMI. Now I feel good about my decision because many of my readers said that the title is very catchy. And it's a title that made them to actually look into the book. So I'm happy with that.
Absolutely. Well, and who do you think will benefit from this book?
The salaried people, especially in the age group of 22 to 50 years, will benefit hugely from this book. And others who suffer in the debt trap can also read this book in order to get practical finance tips to learn to reduce loans and also to avoid loans. You know, whether you may be doing a business or you may be taking care of someone else in your family and you see them suffering from debt, they're in a deep debt trap, then I think this book will be really helpful in order to come out of the debt trap and lead a zero EMI life.
Wonderful. Great. It will definitely help people. Who is your favorite author and why?
There are quite a few. I started reading very late in my life, you know, maybe after starting going to work, then only I started picking this reading habit. Until then, I was only reading the textbooks. The reading habit actually picked up once I started going to work. And I need to tell you, if I need to tell you the topmost favorite author, then it is T.T. Rangarajan, alias Mahatriya. I'm a vivid fan of his Frozen Thoughts monthly magazine, which is now renamed as Infinite Thoughts. Actually, that is more than a magazine. Every aspect of life finds a place in that magazine. Relationship, psychology, health, science, finance, you name it. And you'll find some of the contents and topics or scripts about those topics in that book. I also went ahead to read his other books, Unposted Letter, Most and More, Clarity is Power. He writes so well. You know, what I like the most is his wordplay.
Okay.
I'm unable to recollect some of the wordplays, but he uses the same word in the same sentence multiple times to bring out a different meaning. He plays with words. You know, if you get a chance, you know, read some of his writings, you'll understand what I'm talking about. And I'm greatly inspired by his wordplay.
Okay, is that a monthly magazine?
Yes, that is a monthly magazine. And
okay.
He has also written books like Unposted Letter, Most and More, and Clarity is Power.
Okay, wonderful. Definitely. I'll try to get one for myself as well.
Sure. And let me know after you reading it.
Definitely. Do you like self-publishing or traditional publishing?
This is a wonderful question, actually. Traditional publishing houses have built a legacy. It's not very easy to get an offer from them to publish your book, that too for first-time authors like me. Unless you are a Robin Sharma or a Chetan Bhagat, by the way. Otherwise, it's very difficult. Working with a traditional publisher to get your book reviewed, approved, and published requires huge time investment. And your go-to-market is very long. At the same time, the publisher invests money to publish the money. You don't need to invest the money. And they cannot publish all the books that is being submitted because they are investing money. Right? There is a practical problem that they have and it's not viable for them. I completely understand that. And one other plus point for traditional publishers is they market your books to some extent. They market their publishing house and also some of the prime titles so that your marketing is covered to some extent. The goodwill of the publishing house also helps your book sales. These are some of the advantages of traditional publishing. Some of the examples of traditional publishing houses are like Penguin, Rupa, Jaiko, and there are regional publishers also, like, you know, Vigadan Publishers in Tamil language, you know, who's one of the renowned publisher with 900 plus titles, if I'm not wrong. Amazing bunch of books. On the other hand, nowadays there are n number of thought leaders who actually want to share their knowledge, experience, expertise, and their stories with the world. They are not celebrities. They are not popular. They do not carry a huge legacy, but they possess knowledge. Self-publishing houses help those people to publish their books. They make their dreams a reality. Not only that, your go-to-market time is very short when you come to self-publishing houses. This model also gives a lot of freedom and flexibility to the authors. You can market your book as per your choice.
Wonderful.
You can be as creative as possible to market your books and increase sales. To me, book sales means reaching more and more people. It's not about earning money.
Correct.
In fact, the author spends money to publish a book. I myself have spent money to publish this book. I love to take my message to more and more audience.
Absolutely.
And self-publishing houses publish books in almost any title. It's certainly a boon, not only for first-time authors, but also the readers, as they get an opportunity to read so many varieties of books.
Correct.
More than likes and dislikes, I think self-publishing houses helps to turn your author dreams quickly when compared to traditional publishing houses.
Correct. And in your case, it was Notion Press.
Yes, that's correct.
And how has been your relationship with Notion Press?
Yeah, wonderful actually. They publish so many titles in 1 hour. You know? They work on an on-demand printing model, wherein, you know, as soon as you place an order in Amazon.in or Knock.com, they print the book and deliver it to your doorstep. They have the advanced technology built-in, infrastructure built-in in their publishing house. And they are helping a lot of first-time authors to realize their dreams of publishing the books. And it was really a nice experience working with them.
Wonderful. Great. And Palaniappan, here is another question for you. If you were to meet your younger self, what would you ask him to do differently?
Okay. I'm actually absolutely happy with what life offered me thus far. Few successes and many learning experiences. I truly believe that the failures and learning experience that I had only have shaped me. More than success, I love to embrace failures because it takes me to the next orbit. It's human psychology to think hypothetically, but one must remember that you cannot control many things that happens to you. And it's destined. Whatever happens, happens for a reason. I may sound philosophical, but that's the truth that I believe in. Life is so kind towards me. And it also taught me to count my blessings. So honestly speaking, I really do not want to change anything. Everything works good now.
Wonderful. So you're content.
Yes.
You don't want to change anything. Great. Good to know that. And one more question. How did you manage? Because you said that you were a full-time employee working with the company. How did you manage to write this book along with your full-time job?
This is a wonderful question, Ali. You know, many have this question in mind, right? You know, hey, I'm working full-time. How do I pursue my interests? You know, how do I follow my passion? And I'm so interested, but time doesn't permit me. You know, my full-time job keeps me engaged always.
Right.
How do I really do things that I wanted to do? So let me share my experience. So that may be of some help to those who are thinking in these lines. I'm an early riser. I get up very early in the morning and say roughly about 2 hours every day in the morning I spend to do things of my personal interest, be it writing, be it preparing for speeches. You know, I'm also a public speaker, so I prepare for speeches, be it responding to my personal emails. I use those early morning hours to do all of these. And I also spend my weekends to do some of these activities again, and also to post something in the social media, plus give speeches during the weekends.
Okay.
Sometimes I have also indulged myself, giving that it's not that every day I get up early in the morning and do all of this, right? And it's it become so monotonous. At times I also indulge myself in giving that extra few hours of morning sleep, allow myself to sleep until 7 a.m., 7:30 a.m. But I never regret. Those exceptions actually helped me to energize, in fact. Otherwise, I would have suffered with the monotony. And this is how I manage my time in order to pursue my interest along with my full-time job.
Wonderful. Great. And what would your advice be to aspiring writers and authors?
I'm actually one book old. And I don't think I can advise someone about writing, but I can share what worked well for me to become an author. Once I decided to publish this as a book, I started my planning first of all. The program manager experience came in handy for me for my book writing project. I decided to fix a launch date and then work backwards to decide upon the deadlines for each of the work that needs to be done. Being a first-time author, I was not aware of all the works or tasks that was involved, as I mentioned in your previous question. And I worked with the publisher to get the list of all tasks involved in publishing a book. Once I got those details, then I fixed a deadline for each of those tasks, like completing manuscript, reviewing it, submitting the reviewed manuscript to the publisher, working with the editor to complete the editing, proofreading, sequencing the chapters, cover design, and then finally publishing it. So I established a tracker with all of these tasks and started tracking the progress, like what we do typically in a project. And I had a target of writing minimum 500 words every day to complete the manuscript. And I had a separate tracker for that as well. But you know, not everything works as per the plan, right? We make plan, but you know, implementation is also the key. There were times where I could not write. There were times when I could not do the proofreading. There were times when I could not review the manuscript. Still, the project plan really helped me to stay focused, and it always helped me to bring me back to the track. And it kept reminding me about the launch date. With all these plans and trackers in place, I was able to complete the book writing project successfully with I would say minimum challenges.
Wonderful. And how much time did it take for you to complete this task of writing the book from start to finish?
It took almost 3 months for me to submit the manuscript.
Okay.
And then from there on, it took another 3 months, 3 to 4 months roughly, to get the book out.
All right. Wonderful. And how did you find the course by Ignani on content writing?
Oh, that was wonderful, actually. You know, the course ad is something that I saw in Facebook, and I thought, you know, I must join this course. It was around that time when I was actually writing my manuscript, I think. This course was about content writing. So I enrolled for it, and that was offered to me for free. You know, I still couldn't believe that, you know, such a valuable content being offered graciously by Ignani for free. The person, the facilitator, Mr. Prakash, right?
Bhaskar, sir.
Sorry, I'm sorry, yes. Mr. Bhaskar. Mr. Bhaskar delivered the content flawlessly, and that showed that he possesses a lot of experience, you know, many numbers of experience in developing content and delivering content in various platforms and models. He spoke about the different types of contents and the places wherein your contents can be published, and how to get, you know, content writing projects and all of that, and how to improve your writing skills, what are the tools available to check your grammar, and how to organize your thoughts and put it in a paper in a strong content, and how to develop a strong content. And those are some of the things that he covered, and it's a very exhaustive course, I would say. And I really loved that course, and kudos to Mr. Bhaskar and to Ignani for organizing that course.
Thank you so much for your appreciation of the course. Well, Palaniappan, thank you so much for your time once again, for sharing your thoughts and giving time for this interview. And I strongly recommend the book Zero EMI to everyone who wants to lead a debt-free life. Thank you once again, Palaniappan, for your time.
Thank you so much, Ali. It's very wonderful being associated with Eenani time and again. And it's lovely talking to you. Thank you so much.